How's it going, everybody? My name is Salty and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to be going over the best settings to use here in the Modern Warfare 2 beta. Yeah, so I have been personally playing the game now for about 5 or 6 hours. And I've been digging through the settings, changing things to see what I like. We're going to go over my personal settings here. So that being said, let's just jump right into it. So I'm going to start with a couple of the simple ones here. We're going to go over the best graphic settings. So world motion and weapon motion blur, you're going to want off. So what those do is it makes it blurry as you spin. What can happen there is you can end up missing a target. So I would highly recommend turning those ones off. Yes, it may seem more like you're in the game itself. It's more realistic. But for success, I would definitely recommend turning those off. So for film grain, you're going to want this all the way down at zero. What this does is it adjusts the strength of the visual noise, which kind of makes it look fuzzy, in my opinion. When you turn that down, there's kind of no fuzz or grain to what you're looking at. So sliding down to our depth of field, you're going to want this off. It's somewhat like the motion blur. When you aim down the sights, it blurs everything around you. I'm not a fan of that because you could totally miss someone while aiming, like while you're aiming down the sights, someone could like be in your peripherals and you might not see them because of that blur. So personally, I have that one off. I would highly recommend you do the same. So this setting automatically comes off. It is the Fidelity FX cast. You're going to want this on and turned up to 100. It will just make everything much sharper and crisper. Everybody, I got some questions about my graphic settings. This is the most important one here. It just makes everything sharp. Getting down here, my field view, I have it 110. This is a personal one. Whatever you're comfortable with is what you should be running here. There's no third person field of view, so you don't need to change that. And I don't really feel like I need to cover the brightness or anything like that. Slide over to the next setting here. Over in the audio section, I have my audio mix set at headphone bass boost. If you are using a headset, this one's pretty good to pick up those enemy footsteps. In my gameplay, you can't really hear it, but in my own ears, I can hear those footsteps coming from a mile away. As long as they don't have dead silence, you can hear them basically all around you and you can easily track where they are exactly coming from. I have everything else set on 100 here. The dialogue is one that I probably will end up turning down to 50. That's what I normally do. I don't feel like it's that important. And then the music volume I always have off. Get rid of all those extra distractions because the music does play during the game. I understand some people like the menu music, but the music during the game is a distraction. You can miss someone's footsteps because of that music in general. All right, so we're over here in the interface settings. The only thing I do believe I changed here is going to be my color customization. Just like in Cold War, if you guys are a fan of my channel from that game, I do change the colors. I'm using filter too, because that's where you get the most vibrant colors. That's how it contrasts your game much more. That's how it makes it look more colorful. So filter too is what I suggest running. You don't necessarily have to change the colors if you don't want to, but it's just my preference. I have me set as yellow so I can figure out exactly which one I am on the map. My team and my party set at some sort of blue, my enemy at yellow, and the neutral and contested at white and yellow. So basically you want to turn this world color intensity up to 100. That is what's going to make your game most contrasted and make your game really just stand out, where it's kind of brown and gray. Like the color palette's kind of gray right now. This will really make those colors pop out. And for those who didn't know, I do play on controller. So we're going to jump into my settings. Nothing really changed here from Black Ops Cold War to this. I kept everything basically the same. I have my horizontal and vertical at 8.8, but that's a preference. This one's not all too important. I would keep. Oh, also my ADS multiplier is at 0.8. That one may get brought up because the ADS is a little slow in this game, like the movement of it all. But yeah, 8.8. This is one you guys got to figure out by yourself. Ignore the controller vibration. I have a controller that does not have the vibration in it as is. So we're getting down to here where we have automatic tactical sprint. This is one that I highly recommend. When I was playing Modern Warfare 2019, I screwed up a ton of controllers not running automatic tactical sprint. So I can understand if you're running a shotgun, you're going to want to take this one off, or semi-auto weapons, and you go to hip fire because it won't work very well. But that being said, automatic tactical sprint outside of like semi-auto and the shotguns, I would highly recommend having this on. All right, so over in the advanced section here, we have our advanced controller settings, whatever. This is where you're gonna find your aim assist and everything like that. So target aim assist is what you want on. We have the aim assist type at Black Ops. That's personally what I am most comfortable with. It's the same as the Black Ops Cold War aim assist. I really like that one. In linear, again, just like Cold War, I find these two I have a ton of success with. You personally should play around with them if you don't like this combination, but mix up all your combinations, see what you can find. This is literally the only thing I changed over in advance, just because we don't have, you know, any vehicles, ground war, third person, anything like that. This is probably where you're going to find those settings, but you can find your dead zones here. I didn't change any just because I just got, you know, I'm using a pretty new controller and don't really need to. I'm going to jump over into a gameplay for you guys so you can see what my settings are like live in action. You can see all my graphics, my audio. It's an absolute banger gameplay. I was using the Lock Melis, I believe it's called LMG. I'm not exactly 100% sure on the name of that weapon, but it is one of the LMGs here in the game, which is messing around, ended up with over 50 kills. Chopper Gunner, it was a good game. So without further ado, let's set today's like goal at 156 likes. Let's do our best to absolutely smash that. Let's get into the gameplay. Oh, they spawned there. I've never spawned on that side. Like ever. Visibility is a little rough. You don't need that on PC. I don't even think we have fidelity. I don't know where they're spawning. I got a UAV.
Copy that. UAV is on station.
I ran out of ammo, Clay. Oh, you got him.
Securing Charlie.
No, it wasn't Scavenger that was the problem.
We are losing Bravo.
I had to reload.
Friendly counter UAV is online. Counter UAV.
I got a choppy Ganny. Oh my god!
Securing objective. Enemy securing Bravo. We have lost Bravo.
I'm on a 15 right now. Just don't know where they're spawning. Enemy took Charlie, so I'm watching through this window here. Come on. Oh, coming up there. Oh, they took A. Is you under me?
Got you covered!
Watch my long lane. I gotta put this ammo box down.
Securing objective, Bravo. The enemy holds all objectives. Secure those We are taking Charlie.
Where are we spawning?
Securing objective, Alpha.
I'm on a 20. I don't wanna move.
Alpha secure.
I mean, I do wanna move, but like, I'm scared without this UAV. I just want this advance, bro. Give me the advance of the game. It's
online. Enemy is securing Alpha.
I don't see anybody.
Securing
No, they spawned behind me, bro. I can use the chopper gunner, go. It's okay. I missed all my shots and screwed up.
The enemy has captured two objectives. Move to secure.
This thing good though is the question. And do you control it? Or does it control it?
Enemy is taking alpha. We have lost all objectives. Now UAV is over in the area.
How do I move this thing?
We are taking Bravo.
The L1? Can I not move? Or is it just sit? Oh, there's rockets. I don't mind it. Doing okay. I guess you can't move. It's alright.
Enemy is securing Alpha. Friendly UAV on station. We have lost Alpha.
Hey, can we watch our mouth? Yeah, I'm recording. Couldn't even see him. Yeah, I don't know. It's weird. I didn't even know there was a door there. They just spawn next to people. How much time do I have? Oh, we gotta win the game. Oh, we're tripping out. I'm good. I do not like that streak. I am 3 kills off. Give me a second.
Enemy is taking Bravo.
I'm going to B. I should be able to pick up some kills.
Friendly counter UAV is on station.
UAV.
Requesting recon flyover.
Copy. UAV. Enemy is taking Bravo. Counter UAV standing by.
Reloading.
Secure Bravo.
I gotta reload, dude.
We are taking Bravo.
I have a counter as well. My counter's up.
Secure Bravo. Bravo secure.
No one's back here. 5 more for a nuke. Oh, for jug. Okay.
Changing back.
Counter UAV is
being. I already called my UAV.
We
control two objectives. Enemy is taking Bravo. We have lost Bravo.
You can sprint away while you're reloading. Kinda like that. I have another chopper gunner. I won't. Okay. There was a guy here today. Better call that in. Game's about to end.
Objective Bravo is compromised. Take it back.
Go to B with it. Try to win the game. I gotta go to A quickly.
Objective Alpha is compromised.
Got you back.
Friendly UAV online. Objective Charlie. Securing objective Alpha.
I'm coming. Yeah, they're going A. Probably not. We won, let's go. I have 53, nice. If you guys made it to this point in the video, I want you to go down in the comment section and put best settings. That way I know you made it all the way to the end. I also want to hear your opinion of that LMG. I've been leveling that thing up and I actually think it's one of my more favorite weapons. It's definitely slower paced, but I love the iron sights, love the recoil control and damage range. Overall, it's just felt like the best weapon to me. But again, make sure you go down in the comments if you've had a chance to use that weapon. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you guys hit like and subscribe if you have not already. I'll see you guys in the next one.